right on North District. And so if we could bow in prayer. Most holy and gracious God, we come to you seeking guidance. God, we've done all that we can do, and we ask that you would do for us what we cannot do for ourselves. Father, the violence that we have seen over the course of the last 24 hours has been nothing less than disturbing. It's been scary. And so, God, we ask that you would stand up in our community and help us in this place. Father, we ask that you would touch the families that were affected last night, and even families that were affected by violence before last night. God, we ask that you would encourage our community to stand up and say enough is enough. Help us, God, that we would be able to move forward from this, and that we would be able to walk in the newness of life that you have so graciously bestowed upon us. Father, we thank you. We love you. We honor you. But most of all, God, even in the midst of this, we trust you. It's in Jesus' name that I pray. Amen.
Hello, I'm Sergeant Shane Foley with the IMPD Public Affairs Office. I'm going to provide a brief statement of what we know and can release at this time. Then the mayor and chief will make statements. There'll be a number of questions you have that we will not be able to answer at this time. We understand this is of particular interest to the community, and we'll provide as much information as we can, and we'll release additional information as it becomes available. Just before 4 a.m., IMPD North District officers responded to the 3300 block of East 36th Street on a report of a person shot. Upon arrival, officers located a juvenile male with apparent gunshot wounds. He was transported to an area hospital. Officers later received information that led them to a residence in the 3500 block of Adams Street. Officers entered the residence and located five individuals with apparent gunshot wounds who were all deceased. Of the individuals, one of the individuals was pregnant and transported to an area hospital. Despite the best life-saving efforts provided by medical staff, both the female and the unborn child did not survive. The juvenile male who was shot is expected to survive his injuries. From what we know at the very early stages of this investigation, this does not appear to be a random act. This is a very active investigation. Detectives are still on scene, canvassing the area for witnesses or anyone with information. If anyone has information that will assist detectives, we ask them to call Crime Stoppers at 262-TIPS or the IMPD Homicide Office at 327-3475.
This morning, one or more individuals perpetrated an act of evil in our city. While we're still learning more about the circumstances that led to this incident, I want to be very clear about something. What happened this morning was not an act of simple gun violence. As tragic as a simple act of gun violence is, what happened this morning was a mass murder. The choice of an individual or individuals to bring, and I do not use these words lightly, terror to our community. I've already been in contact with the United States Attorney's Office for the Southern District of Indiana, the Indianapolis Field Office of the Federal Bureau of Investigation, as well as other law enforcement partners. I want those responsible to know that the full might of local, state, and federal law enforcement are coming for them as I speak. Coming for them today, coming for them tonight, coming for them tomorrow, and the day after that. Coming for them as long as it takes to find them. And we will not stop there. We will also determine whether the guns involved in this incident were illegally possessed. If they were, we will identify any individual responsible for illegally providing the gun to those who committed these acts. We will also identify and bring to justice anyone who has or does aid and abet those who are responsible. We will not stop until anyone complicit with this act of violence is held fully responsible. For a decade now, you know this. The city of Indianapolis has engaged in a community conversation as to how we should best address the deadly confluence of guns, substance abuse, and poverty that has seen our city's homicide rate rise to historic highs. Worse yet, the last year has seen a national surge in deadly gun violence, the causes of which are still debated, but almost certainly are, at least in part, tied to the economic and personal anxiety faced by millions of Americans due to a global pandemic. But that is not what happened today. This is a crisis of morality, a crisis of conscience. This morning, the city of Indianapolis was targeted with an act of depravity that has become all too common across the country and will never cease to shock the conscience. I ask anyone who has any knowledge of this crime, now is the time to speak out. Now is the time to come forward. I ask you to call Crime Stoppers. I ask you to talk to detectives. Speak with one of our violence reduction team members. Be the person who says this type of violence, this senseless terror, has no place in our community. Today, Indianapolis has lost much, including an unborn life. Justice will be done. Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department Chief Randal Taylor. Chief.
Thank you, Mayor.
Just this last week, we talked about investments that we're making and resources we're devoting to stopping crime and violence here in Indianapolis. Drug-related crimes, domestic violence, violence driven by poverty or desperation. But what we saw this morning was a different kind of evil. What occurred this morning, based on the evidence that's been gathered so far, was a mass murder. More than that, we believe it was not random. There are no right words to say at this time, a time when our community must come to terms with the largest mass casualty shooting in more than a decade. I myself am heartbroken for the lives that have been taken too soon, for the young life that's forever been changed, and for the life that never got a chance to start. For the neighborhood left to pick up the pieces in the wake of unprecedented violence, and for all of the family and friends that have been rocked by grief. I'm angry that perpetrators felt that they had the right to commit this senseless act in the community, in our community. I'm frustrated for my officers and for the crime scene technicians and for the coroners that have had to spend their day and are still out on that scene and will spend the days to come. But more than that, I'm determined. Determined to hold those accountable that committed this act. Determined to be part of our community's collective healing at this unacceptable crime and the even more trauma that's already burdened our community this year. I'm determined to work alongside every member of this community to ensure that this doesn't happen again. Because we as police can do a lot to improve our neighborhoods, but we simply cannot do it alone. Now, I don't know what to tell you. I don't know what goes through a person's mind. I don't know what kind of lie they listen to in their head that would tell them that pulling the trigger on anybody, but especially on this many people, is the right thing to do. I don't think I really want to know, to be honest with you. But it does have to stop. Our community doesn't deserve this. So please, if you have any information, please call Crime Stoppers anonymously if you have to, 317-262-TIPS, or our homicide office at 327-3475. If you have any information that could help, please help. At this time, we'll try to answer any questions you may have. There's no one to my knowledge that is unaccounted for out of that house. I believe our detectives streamlining their investigation. There are no identifiable suspects at this time. Do believe that there could possibly be more than one shooter. And that's about all I can say about that.
Is the general community in danger, or is this an isolated incident to this specific family in this specific house?
I believe this is isolated to this family in this house. The detectives, like I said, are working the investigation, and as more information comes available, then we'll share that as we get it. It's my understanding that would make it six. Yes. Don't know the particulars of that at this point.
What's your message to the community, those neighbors that woke up to this and saw this happening? What's your message to them?
Just like I said, our prayers are with you. Commander Wally and his people have done a great job. They'll be out there and available to try to comfort them as much as they can. Like I said before, I believe this was not a random act. This was targeted, so I don't think that they're in danger, but obviously I understand their concern for what happened in that neighborhood. Well, next thing for us to do is identify and arrest the people that perpetrated this crime. But in the long run, obviously, we've got to come together as a community working hand in hand in order to stop this violence, because this is a terrible event, obviously, but you know our numbers, our murder numbers were high last year. We don't want to see that repeat this year. So we're going to have to do the things that it takes to come together and figure out a way to stop this. I believe more participation by community members is on the horizon. I think that will certainly help and go a long way.
Chief, with this one, this was six people, six lives. You also have the juvenile who looks like he will survive. But outside of that, in the hours leading up, weren't there at least seven other shootings tonight?
There were a number of shootings, yes.
What does what is the message to the people who just think it's okay to just shoot people?
Well, I think the mayor and I have been very clear. It's not okay. There is a problem. Like I said, I don't know what goes through a person's mind that thinks that shooting is going to solve a problem. You know, whether you're shooting because money is owed or whether it's a respect issue or whatever, none of that really makes sense. And it doesn't, it doesn't move your life forward if you do those things. All you've done is created a time for yourself, a life for yourself, where you're always going to be looking over your shoulder, wondering who's coming, whether it's law enforcement or someone else.
What was your first thought when you got this call this morning after this and the other shooting?
Well, when I look at those pages, I think the first one I recognized was a shooting. Then when I saw the number of people at that time, I didn't know what their condition was, but that came in a little bit later. It breaks your heart. That's why I came out. Nothing I can do with it. The detectives and the officers on the street had done a fine job of securing the scene and doing whatever they could, but I wanted to come out here and support and be here. But these are things that stay with me.
I think we were just talking last week. I think, was that when you were?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And we talked about how you can't prevent all of these things, but in the post of it, are there enough detectives? Are there enough officers and mayor and counselor to get these cases wrapped up? So we had a whole conversation this morning with folks who have been waiting 16 months because their family had a member that was murdered. Do you guys have the resources to follow these?
Well, we've got dedicated men and women that are working it. I won't say we couldn't use more. That's something we could certainly look at. I think it's concerning that we have to have this many detectives assigned to homicide in the first place. Really, as a community, we shouldn't have to be there. I've said over and over, the mayor and the council have done a great job with giving us staff that we need and the officers that we need, but we can't be everywhere at the same time to prevent these things. And unfortunately, until we can get over people's desire to shoot and kill, then we're going to have problems.
A question for the mayor. Sir, you rolled out the 2021
Well, Russ, I want to be clear. We take any act of violence, gun violence, very seriously. But absent having a police officer in every home in our community, given what I understand the investigators are finding, I'm not sure there's any particular thing that we could have done to prevent. Let me be clear about this. When we talk about public safety generally and improving public safety in the city of Indianapolis, the types of violence that we have sought to see decline are the programs and the policies that we propose in our 2021 rollout. Those are largely they are designated to address crimes of passion, crimes of retaliation, crimes of self-defense, crimes of desperation. But that is not what occurred in the city of Indianapolis this morning. What occurred this morning in our city, based on the evidence that has been gathered so far, was nothing short of a mass murder. We are charged with the responsibility of protecting our residents, and we will. And to the question about the manhunt, every federal, state, and local law enforcement official, in his or her own way, is helping work this case and all the other cases. But what happened this morning in the city of Indianapolis was fundamentally different than what we've been struggling against the last 5 or 6 years. I'm sorry? Yeah, I have no idea what the motivation was. That will be determined pursuant to the investigation. But I do think there's a fundamental difference. Not that any crime of gun violence is acceptable under any circumstance, but when it is a crime of passion or retaliation, that is one thing. It is a completely different thing for a trigger puller, or perhaps several trigger pullers, to walk into one home and kill six people. And that is why we are here today.